हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, माय नेम इज़ विवेक प्रसाद सो आई एम वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन द टेक्सटाइल टेक्नोलॉजी डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ MLV टेक्सटाइल इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज. इट इज़ लोकेटेड इन भीलवाड़ा, राजस्थान. द वीडियो लेक्चर इज रिलेटेड टू द सब्जेक्ट मल्टी फाइबर स्पिनिंग विच इज़ फॉर द फाइनल ईयर टेक्सटाइल टेक्नोलॉजी स्टूडेंट्स. एंड द टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन ऑफ दिस वीडियो इज टाइप्स ऑफ वेस्ट generated in spinning. What is waste? Waste is basically a process of, or it is a material. Waste is a material which is lost in a process, either intentionally or due to some carelessness. So due to some carelessness also the waste can be generated, and intentionally waste has to be generated in some of the process, like in spinning. In spinning, in many of the processes, intentionally waste has to be generated because to improve the quality of the yarn. So depending on the sources of waste, depending on the process, and depending on the end use of the waste, there are various classification of the waste. Mainly, now classification of waste. Mainly, the waste can be classified into two groups: process waste and reusable waste. There may be other classifications also. Before discussing these classification, there may be other classifications also, like hard waste and soft waste. Now, hard waste and soft waste. What is the difference between the two? Soft waste is the loose fiber material, and hard waste is the waste generated after spinning, means generated after inserting twist in the fibers. So there may be other classification also, like product waste and process waste. So in product waste, the waste can be reused, which is here written as reusable waste. It can also be written as product waste. And process waste, process waste is that it is required, it is the necessity to produce a good quality of material. We need to remove few of the undesired materials or few of the parts of the raw material, a portion of the raw material which is undesired or which gives hindrance to the quality of the final end use or quality of the final end product. So there may be another classification, third classification, usable waste or non-usable waste. Means usable waste, which can be this reusable waste, and non-usable waste, this can be written as non-usable waste. So reusable waste, which is again the waste is again processed in the same process of manufacturing. And non-usable, it means it has to be sold somewhere. Now process waste, types of process waste generated in spinning and particularly in cotton spinning. So these are the various stages at which the waste is generated: blow room, guarding, comber, draw frame, different machines, winding or spinning. So in blow room, generally the waste generated are beater droppings, filter waste, contamination cotton. Okay, in blow room, these waste are first three categories of waste are generated. In guarding, flat strip, mainly flat strip and licorine waste. In comber, noil is the main category of waste generated in comber. In draw frame, fan waste, and all machines, sweeping waste. And in winding and spinning, yarn waste. So beater dropping, as we know, we have to remove the trash particles in blow room for cleaning of the material. So beater waste is that particular trashy material. This is filter waste. This basically comes from the humidification plant, because the air which is actually blow room, from the word blow room is from is coming from blowing of air. So the material is transported through air, and that air has to be filtered. The waste material has to be collected somewhere. Okay. So in this process, the filtering of air, the dust particles are deposited in the filter, and they are accumulated, and they are all known as filter waste. This is contamination cotton. As we know, there are various machines in the blow room line which removes contamination, and those machines are called contamination clearer machine. So overall, in blow room, if we calculate the percentage of waste generated in blow room, and the percentage is to be calculated on the basis of the raw material taken in the blow room. So if we calculate that percentage of waste, it should be around 2.5 to 3.5 depending on the type of raw material, whether it is a Indian cotton or imported cotton. So it may vary from 2.5 to 4.4, it may go up to 4.5 also. So on an average, the value should be around 3 to 3.5. Okay. In carding, the main waste are generated flat strips and liquorine waste. Again, liquorine waste contains much of the seed coat material, trash material, and flat strips are containing the short fibers which are removed in the carding between the cylinder and flat, and also it has got nappy materials in the flat strip. And the percentage of this type of waste generated in carding may vary around 7 to 8%, okay, depending on the type of raw material. Even for imported cotton, it may be low as 4 to 5% also, but in general we can say that 7 to 8% should be the waste generated in carding. Comber, the noil, as we know that we need to remove the short fiber for producing the combed yarn. So it depends on the quality and count of the yarn which needs to be produced, and also on the raw material, how much the raw material is containing the short fibers. So in generally we can say that it varies from 14 to 18%, on an average around 16%. Okay, so as we know that these are process waste. These waste are not used in the same process, but that might be used in different processes to produce some inferior quality of products. Like comber noil is generally used in rotor spinning for producing open end yarn. Now drawing. In drawing, fan waste is generated. Where does from fan waste, this fan waste is coming from? Where it is coming from? The drafting zone, where the short fibers are sucked through the vacuum fan. So these are collected in a filter of the fan, where the air is filtered. So this fan waste is coming from drawing, different types of drawing machines, sweeping waste. These are the material which somehow got to the ground, somehow has fallen to the ground. So when the ground needs to be cleaned with the help of by sweeping, these waste are generated. So these waste cannot be, these are dirty waste. They may be containing a longer fibers, some piecing material, but they cannot be reused. Now yarn waste, this is generally the main category of hard waste, which is generated in winding or ring spinning. Main portion of the yarn waste is coming from winding. Where from it is coming? It is coming by clearer cuts. When the winding machine is getting rid of that faults, it cuts the yarn and the hard waste is produced. So in totality, this fan waste, sweeping waste and yarn waste should be, in totality, these three waste should be around 1 point less or equal to 1.5%, not more than that. It should be around, on an average, 1.5, depending on the type of yarn quality and the process. So this was all about the process waste generated in the cotton spinning. main categories of reusable waste generated in cotton spinning. Lab bits, these are generated where in blow room, in old blow room and carding line, where lab feeding is there, where there is no chute feeding, there is lab feeding. So the pieces of the lab material may be one of the reusable source of reusable waste. Sliver waste in carding, comber, draw frame, simplex, wherever there is a sliver breakage, we need to piece the sliver, do the piecing, and there may be sliver waste. And also when the batches change, means suppose in draw frame the cans which are fed are exhausted, so all the bottom of the raw material is available on the can is not used. These are converted into sliver waste. So that may be a source of reusable waste. So these waste are having good quality of cotton and they are reused. Roving waste coming from simplex. Suppose in simplex, a roving bobbin has got some kind of fault, and it has become a rejectable bobbin, and it needs to be removed from the process. So, due to the fault in the simplex bobbin, roving waste is coming. We need to empty that bobbin and then again utilize it. So their roving waste is coming, and is from spinning also, because of the changing of batches, there is a generation of roving waste. In spinning ring frame, Nema fill waste. What is this Nema fill waste? Whenever a yarn is broken during spinning, the roving is going into the suction of the ring frame of the individual drafting zone. As you know, there is a pipe beneath the delivery roller to suck the material. Otherwise, what will happen? The material will fly all over the ring frame, and it will create further breakages and also generate faults. So the material, the loose roving which is coming from the delivery before twisting, it goes into the, since it is broken, so it is in the loose form and it goes into the suction of the front roller, suction tube of the beneath the front roller. So it becomes a Nema fill waste. Bonda waste is also known as clearer waste. It is the clear coming from the clearer or the fleece rollers which are located on the top of the rubber rollers in the drafting zone, top of the top rollers. And the function of the clearers is to remove the short fiber and to prevent the roller lapping. So these are the reusable waste. So these waste in totality, the mainly the Nema fill waste and bondas are in the range of around 1.5 to 2%. It may vary from 1 to 2%, this Nema fill and bonda waste. And the rest of the waste should be lesser than, in each process it should be lesser than 0.5, around 0.2 to 0.3. sliver waste also 0.2 to 0.3, roving waste also around 0.2 to 0.3. so in totality this should be around 3 to 4% in totality the reusable waste, in maximum 5%. So we have to use this good quality of material again in the blow room, in the lay down. So the reusable waste should not exceed 5%. In general, the norm says that it should be around 3%. Again, this slide is showing the same thing which I discussed in the previous slide, reusable waste. This usable waste added in the mixing should not exceed 3%, but practically it varies from 3 to 5% in the spinning mills. Lab bits at blow room and card, it should be less than 0.5%. sliver waste, card, comber, draw frame should not exceed 0.5% total production. Roving waste at simplex and spinning should not be more than 0.2 and pneumophile at spinning should not be more than 2.5%. This pneumophile completely depends on the breakage rate at the ring frame. So in totality, if we add upon it, it becomes 3.2. So usually the waste should, in the mixing, should not exceed 2-3%.